Acetylsalicylic acid is one of the most famous compounds in modern medicine. It's claimed to treat pain and inflammation and fever and may even prevent heart attacks. But is the drug known as aspirin really the wonder drug we were promised? Hey there, Bays. Trace here for DNews. Thanks for tuning in. Around 400 BCE, Hippocrates' writings claimed the bark of the willow tree could be ground into a powder and used to heal headaches, pains, and fevers. Hippocrates was the father of modern medicine, and his remedy actually worked. It was used for hundreds of years, still used today, and it wasn't until 1829 that scientists discovered a compound in the bark called salicin was the true medical culprit. Salicin does cure the headache, but it's really hard on the stomach, and it can cause bleeding in the digestive tract. Not a great trade-off. Allegedly, a French chemist found when mixed with sodium and acetyl chloride, the resulting acetylsalicylic acid was soft on the tummy and it fixed the swelling. Based on historical records uncovered by BMJ, it was then later retested and sold as aspirin by F. Bayer and Company. But it wasn't until the 1970s that British scientists figured out why acetylsalicylic acid works, which won them a Nobel Prize, by the way. Acetylsalicylic acid is a simple compound, C9H8O4. It reduces pain by messing with the body's production of prostaglandins, a hormone-like lipid compound formed by enzymes in the body. Pain is a pretty confounding thing for scientists because it's so subjective. But physically, when damaged, tissues release chemicals like prostaglandins, which tell your brain to trigger. So when you take acetylsalicylic acid, let's just call it ASA from now on, it binds with the enzyme COX-2. Without the COX-2, the production of the prostaglandin drops, and boom, no more headaches or inflammation-based aches and pains. The problem is, prostaglandin doesn't just do one thing. It has a number of other uses in the body. An enzyme called COX-1 also binds with ASA, and COX-1 has the rather important job of keeping your stomach lining thick. I don't know about you, but I'd rather my stomach acid didn't eat me and just digested my lunch. Prostaglandins also affect how well platelets initiate blood clotting, and ASA somehow has an effect on the hypothalamus region of the brain, responsible for controlling body temperature, which is how it brings down a fever. So after all of this, it makes a lot more sense how ASA can help with things like heart attacks. If blood platelets don't clot as well, they don't cause as many blockages. When the body's fever is reduced, we feel less sick. And of course, moving joints around is kind of the best thing. And studies are exploring how ASA can be recruited to do a lot of other things. In 2014, the Queen Mary University of London found people who took low doses of ASA daily could reduce their risk of death by some cancers by 35 to 50%. Though, that did increase the risk of stomach bleeding by about 3%, and you'd have to take it every single day for a decade just to see any benefit. And a new 2015 study in PLOS ONE found that ASA might bind to another enzyme called GAPDH, which causes our cells to die on purpose. By inhibiting cell death, the thinking is, it might be able to stop Alzheimer's, Huntington's, or Parkinson's dead in their tracks. The thing is, even though it can do a lot for the human condition, treating ASA or aspirin as a miracle wonder drug is a vast oversimplification. Children should not ingest ASA. It's part of a family of drugs which can cause fatal liver failure. And while it can reduce the risk of a second heart attack, the FDA says very specifically it will not prevent stroke or heart attack for people with no history of either issue. And for those required to take aspirin daily, safety-coated or enteric aspirin is coated to keep the ASA from releasing into your stomach and thinning the lining, but it's not a solution really in that the coating releases the drug further in your digestive tract, potentially causing bleeding in the small intestine and then in the stomach once the ASA gets into your bloodstream. There's no escaping science. In the end, this willow bark derivative sure is amazing, hat tip Hippocrates, but it ain't magic. For some people though, aspirin every day is recommended by their doctor, and the best way to remember to take it is just add it to your daily routine, just like a good shave. Finding the perfect gift from Harry's couldn't be easier. If you go to harrys.com right now, as a special offer for y'all, Harry's will give you $5 off your first order. Just use the code DNews. Economy shipping for the holidays ends December 18th, so act now. If you're watching this after that, still act now. Harry's makes every morning feel like a holiday. What do you guys think of all this? Does it make you worry about aspirin, or are you still gonna take it? Let us know in the comments. Keep coming back here to DNews every day. Subscribe. We'll catch you next time.